special. There's great excitement here at the moment, as we should be getting the first result through any moment now. We don't know where it'll be from. It might be from Leicester or from Luton. The polling's been quite heavy in both areas. Oh, wait a moment. I'm just getting a loud buzzing noise in my left ear. Excuse me, man. Straight over to James Gilbert at Leicester.
Well, it's a straight fight here at Leicester. On the left of the returning officer, you can see Arthur Smith, the sensible candidate, and his agent. And on the other side is the silly candidate, Jethro Walrus Titty, with his agent and his wife.
Here is the result for Leicester. Arthur J. Smith.
Sensible party.
30,612. Jethro Q. Walrus Titty.
Silly party.
32,108.
Well, there's the first result, and the silly party have held Leicester. What do you make of that, Norman?
Well, this is largely as I predicted, except that the silly party won. I think this is mainly due to the number of votes cast. Gerald.
Well, there's a swing here to the silly party, but how big a swing, I'm not going to tell you.
Well, if I may, I think the interesting thing here is the big swing to the silly party, and of course, the very large swing back to the sensible party, and a tendency to wobble up and down in the middle because the screw's loose.
I'm afraid I can't think of anything.
I can't add anything to that. Colin!
I just butt in at this point and say this is, in fact, the very first time I've ever appeared on television.
No, we haven't time because we're going straight over to Luton.
Here at Luton, it's a three-cornered fight between Alan Jones, sensible party, in the middle, Tarquin, Fim, Tim, Lim, Bim, Wim, Bim, Lim, Bus, Stop, Fatang, Fatang, Ole, Biscuit Barrel, silly party, and Kevin Phillips, Bong, the slightly silly candidate.
Alan Jones.
On the left, sensible party.
9,112. Kevin Phillips, Bong.
On the right, slightly silly.
Naught. Tarquin, Fim, Tim, Lim, Bim, Wim, Bim, Limbus, Stop, Fatang, Fatang, Ole, Biscuit Barrel.
Silly.
12,441.
And so the silly party has taken Luton.
Again for the silly party at Luton, the first gain of the election. Norman.
Well, this is a highly significant result. Luton, normally a very sensible constituency with a high proportion of people who aren't a bit silly, has gone completely gaga.
Do we have the swing at Luton?
Well, I've worked out the swing, but it's a secret.
There isn't the swing. How about the swan?
Well, I've got the swan here in this box, and it's looking fine. I can see through the breathing holes that it's eating up peanuts at a rate of knots.
And how about the swing?
Well, it's 29% up over 600 feet, but it's a little bit soft around the edges about...
What do you make of the nylon dot cardigan and plastic mule rest?
There's no such thing!
Thank you, Spike.
Can I just come in here and say that the swan has choked itself to death?
Well, the election's really beginning to hot up now.
I can't add anything to that.
Can I just say at this point this is in fact the second time I've ever appeared on television?
I'm sorry, Sasha, we're just about to get another result.
Oh, from Harpenden. Now, this is a key seat because in addition to the official silly candidate, there is an independent, very silly candidate who may split the silly vote.
Mr. Elsie...
silly?
26,317. James Walker.
Sensible.
26,380.
That was close.
Malcolm, Peter, Brian, Telescope, Adrian, Umbrella Stand, Jasper, Wednesday, Stoat Gobbler, John, Raw Vegetable, Arthur, Norman, Michael, Featherstone, Smith, Northcott, Edwards, Harris, Mason, Frampton, Jones, Fruit Bat, Gilbert, will keep a welcome. Williams, if I could walk that way, Jenkins. Tiger Draws, Pratt, Thompson,
raindrops keep falling on my head.
Darcy, Carter, Pussycat,
don't sleep in the subway.
Barton, Mannering, Smith.
Very silly. Oh, there you have it. A sensible gain here at Driffield.
Norman.
Well, I've just heard from Luton that my aunt is ill. Possibly gastroenteritis, Gerald.
Well, if this were repeated over the whole country, it'd probably be very messy. Colin.
Can I just
butt in and say here that it's probably the last time I shall ever appear on television?
No, I'm afraid you can't. We haven't got time. Just to bring you up to date with a few results that you may have missed, Engelbert Humperdinck has taken Barrow in Furness. That's a game from Anne Hayden-Jones and her husband, Pip. Arthur Negus has held Bristol's. That's not a result. That's a bit of gossip. And Mary Whitehouse has just taken Umbridge. Could be a bit of trouble there. Apparently, Wales is not swinging at all. No surprise there. And Monty Python has held the credits.